His plane had barely kissed British soil when the briefing about him began. The Chancellor had returned home to be fired. The Prime Minister was about to perform a major U-turn on her mini-budget.
But it is clear that parts of our mini-budget went further and faster than markets were expecting. So the way we are delivering our mission right now has to change. We need to act now to reassure the markets of our fiscal discipline. I have therefore decided to keep the increase in corporation tax that was planned by the previous government. This will raise £18 billion per year.
But government humiliations like this demand sacrifices to be made, and Kwasi Kwarteng's was the head to roll.
I met the former Chancellor earlier today. I was incredibly sorry to lose him. He is a great friend, and he shares my vision to set this country on the path to growth. Today, I have asked Jeremy Hunt to become the new Chancellor. He's one of the most experienced and widely respected government ministers and parliamentarians.
A new Chancellor after just 39 days as Prime Minister and sacked for tax pledges which she won the Tory leadership race championing. After Liz Truss awkwardly scanned the crowd, searching out just four journalists she had agreed to take questions from, their questions were brief but brutal.
Can you explain to the public why you think you should remain as Prime Minister, given you've junked a key tax cut that led you to be elected?
Will you apologise to your party?
Given everything that has happened, what credibility do you have to continue governing?
He has to go because of the fallout from it. How come you get to stay?
Well, my priority is making sure we deliver the economic stability that our country needs. That's why I had to take the difficult decisions I've taken today. The mission remains the same. We do need to raise our country's economic growth levels.
I now call the Chancellor of the Exchequer to make a statement. Chancellor.
This was just 3 weeks ago today. The newly installed Chancellor making his fiscal statement. Billions of pounds of unfunded tax cuts.
But I'm not going to cut the additional rate of tax today, Mr. Speaker. I'm going to abolish it altogether.
And this was the first tax cut to be U-turned on.
This is a humiliation, Chancellor.
After markets dived and the cost of government borrowing soared, investors across the globe spooked that Britain's finances no longer looked like a safe bet. At lunchtime today, after meeting with Liz Truss, Mr. Kwarteng left Downing Street, no longer Chancellor. And then came the letters and mixed messages from the now former Chancellor and his Prime Minister. In his very first line, Mr. Kwarteng wrote, "You have asked me to stand aside as your Chancellor. I have accepted." While Liz Truss responded, "I deeply respect the decision you have taken today."
So what do you hope to achieve as the new Chancellor?
We'll have lots of chances to collaborate.
If calming the markets is what Jeremy Hunt hopes to achieve, today has not been a success. The interest rates on 10-year government debt remain stubbornly high, while the pound actually fell slightly against the dollar.
I think she won't last out next week, let alone Christmas. So her speech today was frankly, I mean, I have no words to describe what she was saying in Downing Street earlier on. It was awful.
Liz Truss's press conference today lasted just 8 minutes and 54 seconds.
Thank you very much, everybody.
Prime Minister, you're out of your depth, aren't you, Prime Minister? You're out of your depth.
Shock, not just in the room, but a reaction reflected in the markets and among her own MPs, many of whom think 39 days of Liz Truss is enough.
Liz Truss had to persuade her own MPs and her own party. Has she gone anywhere towards doing the trick?
No. In short, I mean, you were in that room. I think we all heard how shocked you were. And literally, as you were standing up after that press conference, I was getting text messages from Tory MPs saying they thought that press conference had made matters worse. One of them was from an MP who had previously been a Liz Truss backer. There is open talk now among MPs about replacing her. That appears to be the majority view. The only thing they can't really agree on is the how and the who. How do they actually get rid of her? Who do they replace her with? And that not being able to get an agreement on that seems to be what is keeping her political career alive right now, albeit on life support.